Hey friends, welcome to another episode of Smart Drive. This is your host Vishwajit. Today we'll be having a special session on EV, that is electric vehicles. Yes, in India now we have a trending situation in the automobile industry that we are totally dependent on the electric cars and their new features, because the diesel engines have already abandoned by major of car manufacturers. And we have found that Sia's Ertiga and also few more successful models were already being terminated to be manufactured. So what will be the real scenario within next 1 or 2 years? We'll have a special discussion on it. So first and foremost, we need to discuss the minute details about the electric vehicles. So electric vehicles are nothing but the battery driven, induction motor driven cars. So they will really make a big difference in the automobile industry. But let's just discuss this all in session of 20 successive episodes, which will be broadcasted on every Saturday 7 p.m. So first of all, we will discuss about how the electric cars are good or bad and why they are necessary for today's era. So in this first episode, we will be discussing some important factors you need to know about the electric vehicles. If you are considering these electric vehicles are totally eco-friendly, so this is not completely true. There are three major reasons you can't connect the eco-friendliness with these electric vehicles. In India, 64% of electricity, that is 221,000 megawatt electricity, is generated with the coal thermal plants. The coal is nothing but one of the main extraction done by India from 7 different states. And this is the major power source we currently use. And we all know that the carbon dioxide emission of these coal power plants is very hazardous to nearby places. Let me clear you that the highest percentage of efficiency is 41%. And in India, we have recorded 26% efficiency only. So that will be definitely a big loss in case of environment itself, because we are using the thermal energy power plant and it is emitting carbon dioxide on a huge level. The second most important point not connecting to electric vehicles to the eco-friendliness is the battery. Today we are using lots of batteries, but lithium ion is in the trend right now. We can rely on lithium-ion batteries for their power and power dissipation as well quick charging. But in India, we don't have lithium mines. So the extraction done outside the India will already making a larger effect on the cost of lithium-ion batteries. This will not only affect your pocket, but as well the lithium extraction itself is not eco-friendly process. And the third and important point that we have already discussed, due to this electricity charges as well making a big induction motor as well giving a better efficient battery, will cost you 30 to 40% more than your usual fuel driven cars. So this is not at all recommended by anyone to pay extra 40% money for the same features and same impact. So this was all about the negative issues we have connected with the electric vehicles. But there are positive sides too. So let's discuss these positive sides now. So while considering the benefits of electric vehicles, we have the first and foremost important point, that is pollution generated by car itself. We all know that we have a dense metropolitan cities all around the globe. So in that case, we have lots of issues regarding the air pollution created by these vehicles. So in case you have started the electric vehicle use in the metropolitan city, we will definitely have a big impact on the air pollution. The second most important point is the noise pollution. So noise pollution is majorly done by the car engines as well the horns. So in case you have eliminated the car engine noise, it will definitely make a bigger change in the lifestyle of any metropolitan city. As we all know, the noise pollution had done a very bad impact on human health in the recent years. From nausea to the heart attacks, we have a noise pollution victims all over the globe. So this will be definitely useful in the metropolitan cities. And the third important point, after buying this vehicle, you need not to worry about any more critical parts like diesel filter, fuel filters, air filter, or any hoses or coolants. These parts are not required in electric vehicle. There is only one induction motor. And these induction motors are very much efficient. They regenerate the energy when you are not paddling the throttle. In case you are not using the energy, it will really make zero impact on the battery. There will be no drainage of the battery. So in that all senses, this will making a big effect on the service life of any induction motor. Please note, if you are really much curious about the maintenance issue of any car, the electric cars are the best to use, because in case you have any servicing issue, you just need to replace or repair your induction motor. That's it. That must be really much effective in all senses. So these were three main positive points and negative points of electric vehicles. So please stay tuned for next Saturday 7 p.m. for next episode. We will be coming with the special statistics for you, and it will definitely make you a good decision maker during your next purchase. So we are also giving a special link in the description. As well, we run one website, that is smartdrive333.com, which will give you more information as well, quick purchase links to all car accessories. Thanks for watching. This is Vishwajit signing off from SmartDrive.